So in the previous lecture, we, from the very simple equation of the conservation of energy, we derived the Schrödinger wave equation, which was minus h bar square over 2a curly square sine over curly x square plus v of sine equals e sine. This was the time-independent Schrödinger wave equation, and this portion, which is minus h bar square over 2m curly square over curly x square plus v, we define this thing as an operator which we call the Hamiltonian operator. And if I write for this E minus h bar square over 2m curly square sine over curly x square plus v sine is equal I h bar curly sine over curly t. Then this is the time dependent Schrödinger wave equation. And so far, we have proved that the expectation value, for example, the expectation value of x from minus infinity to plus infinity psi conjugate x sine dx. About expectation value, you will have to clear one thing, that expectation value is the average value of all the measurements on same system, right? On identical samples of the same system. It is not the average of all measurements. It is the average of each individual measurement on a separate system, same system but identical copies of that system. For example, you are measuring the position of a particle in a sample, which is in electron. For example, you are measuring the position of an electron in a sample. You did measurement once, now that sample you will not use again, but you will have an identical sample in another, and you will measure the sample, the electron position. Then in another sample, the same sample means identical copy of that sample, and you will measure again this thing. And then you will average all these measurements. So what's the difference? The difference is that it is not like 100 times you did measurement on one system and you take the average of the measurements. Okay, we did the normalization condition as well, and this was from minus infinity to plus infinity sine mod square dx will be equal to 1. That the wave function will be normalized. This sign is actually a function of x and t. Now, if I say whether this function will remain normalized for all the time, so the answer is yes. It should remain normalized. From minus infinity to plus infinity, the wave function should be somewhere. This is something that if you are measuring, normalization is if you are measuring the length of a row. So how you can measure the length of a row? If both the ends are with you, then you can measure the length of the row. If none of the end is in your axis, then you cannot say what is the length of this row, right? Or if one end is with you and the other end is not in your axis, you cannot measure the length of that row. Both the ends should be with you. So both the ends are minus infinity and plus infinity, the maximum. and this will be equal to 1. Now the question is that the wave function that we use in Schrödinger wave equation here is actually already normalized. Unless and until a wave function is not normalized, unless and until the wave function is normalized, you cannot use this thing in Schrödinger wave equation. If you solve the Schrödinger wave equation, the wave function that will come out will be actually a normalized wave function. It will not be a non-normalized wave function. So, we said that any function, if you want to find the expectation value of it from minus infinity to plus infinity, it will be psi conjugate and f of x and psi and dx. So it will remain, you can say the expectation value, the average value will be like this. Okay, so the question is whether this wave function will remain normalized for all the time. So the answer is yes. And how we will prove this? If I do derivate this side from minus infinity to plus infinity, psi mod square dx. If I derivate this with respect to time, then this one means this is constant, so this should be equal to 0. So if I do derivate this one and it gives me 0, then it means the wave function is constant in time. The wave function is preserving the same status that it will remain normalized when this thing is equal to 0. So let's prove this thing. So for the proof, I'm starting from here. So the proof of it, let's start d over dt. Now I will not write the minus infinity to plus infinity because it is understood that the limits are these, and sin xt means this is the function of space and time, and this thing is equal to, if I move this n, then I can write curly by curly t, and psi I will now omit x and t because it is understood, and this and dx and the integral. Now further I can write that this thing will be equal to curly by curly t, and let's first prove this one. Then what is curly by curly t psi mod square? Then we will put the value back there and we will do the integration. So this will be curly by curly t, and this will be psi conjugate psi. And now you know to apply the product rule, and this will be first function into derivative of the second function plus second function into derivative of the first function. Cancelled by curly t. Now you know about the fact from here that curly psi by curly t is equal to this thing, right? So I can do right from here, from the Schrödinger wave equation, I can write that from Schrödinger wave equation, I can write that curly psi over curly t is equal. I will have to divide this side by I h bar. So it will be my 1 over I h bar and minus h bar square over 2n curly square sine over curly x square plus 1 over I h bar and curly, this is v and sine. Clear? Just dividing this by I h bar and I will get curly psi by curly t. So now this can be simplified, that curly psi over curly t You can simplify this one. H bar 1 cancels with this one. This is I and this is minus 1. So this is I squared. It means it will come out to be I h bar over 2n. Curly square psi over curly x square plus 1 over I h bar and v psi. So I can write this thing like this. And now, what about, means you can write this one, like this as well. If you move this I up, then minus sign will come with it. Because if I multiply by minus 1 and divide by minus 1, then this minus will become minus here, and this minus 1 will become I squared, and I will cancel with it. So it is very general thing that if you want to move the I up, then you will have to write it minus I when it goes up. So this is clearly psi by infinity, and if I take the conjugate of this one, then what you will do? Wherever there is I, it will become minus I, and wherever is psi, it will become psi conjugate. So this will become minus I h bar over 2m, and this will become curly square psi conjugate by curly x square, and this will become plus I over h bar v psi. Now you are having the value of curly psi by curly t and the value of curly psi conjugate by this one, and I can put this, let's say, is equation 2, this equation 3, and this is your equation 1. So you can put the values, put 1, put 2 and 3 and 1. So you can write that curly by curly t and psi mod square is equal to, now you will have to put the values, and here put the values. So psi conjugate, and now put the value of curly psi by curly t. So this value is I h bar over 2m curly square psi over curly x square minus I over h bar and v psi plus this one psi and curly psi conjugate. So it is minus I h bar over 2m and curly square psi conjugate by curly x square plus I over h bar in v sin. Is it right? So now you can do the simplification, and the simplification is not that difficult. Okay, here this one will be conjugate. Similarly, this one will be conjugate here. So you can simplify this one. And if you look here, what will be this one? Forget about this term, we will simplify it later, but look at this term first. This is psi conjugate minus I h bar v and psi conjugate psi, so psi mod square. This one is plus I h bar and v and psi conjugate psi. So whether you multiply psi with psi conjugate or psi conjugate with psi, it will become psi mod square. So these two are actually cancelling each other. And you are only left with this one. And this is equal. If I take I over h bar 2m is common, then this will be equal to psi conjugate curly square psi over curly x square, and then minus here and psi and curly square
psi conjugate over 30 x squared.
This will be equal to this. And now, further, I can simplify this one. If I write curly by curly x, and then I write I h bar over 2m, and then this one, means I h bar is common, so I can now take in this one. And I have taken curly by curly x is common. Like common means that this will operate on this and you will get back your result. So why I am doing this? Because here I need integration of this thing. And integration is on x. So if I make this one curly by curly x, so in integration this will cancel and I will have this value. Right? So I'm just transforming it into that form, and this thing is equal to psi conjugate and curly psi over curly x minus curly psi and curly psi conjugate over curly x. Means you have taken one derivative out of it. When this will operate on this one, again you will have, because this one is out of it, this it will become curly square by curly x square, and this will become curly square by curly x square. So I have finally this one, and now I will have to put the value of this one into this equation. So this equation, the d over dt of psi mod square dx will be equal to this one. So g over dt of this will be why not to put the value directly here. So put the value of this one directly here, and this the integral. This integral and then curly by curly x. So this curly by curly x will now become here d by dx, because I have solved this one. So this is d by dx, because this is only an x, and I h bar over 2m and sine conjugate curly psi by curly x plus, this is minus, and psi